Alright, so what's going on, people? We're back out here on the farmstead and we got another big project starting today. We're going to start putting up fence today. We've had a few instances of deer or raccoon or whatever they may be, most likely deer because I can see footprints or hoof prints coming in here and just devouring our sunflowers. And the corn is starting to grow. That's next. And who knows what else is next? Possibly the kale. Notice that since I put in these solar buzzers that make a sound every time anything moves around it, the corn hasn't been attacked yet, but it's starting to develop that corn. You can see that coming in. So before those get attacked, those tassels, and turn into corn, before that gets attacked, then I want to start erecting this fence. So this is going to be a two-stage project. I'm going to put the corners in for the T-posts. I've got 8-foot T-posts. And you can see this is not really even terrain, but I've got a straight path leading from this edge coming all the way through to this edge. Where I'm going to run into trouble, because I've come out, this is about, I'd say 50, maybe even 60 feet. I don't know, maybe. But the problem is going to be here. I can move some of this stuff over, definitely get it out the way with the tractor. But if I want to come here, you can see there's not a straight edge going to this next corner. So what I'm going to have to do is come here and sort of get the fence or the T-post to wrap around things that I want. So things that I want inside the garden, the pond, this bird feeder. I can move the bird feeder inside the pond. That's not an issue. So definitely I'm going to have to come in, because I can't put the fence too far out because I have to use this as a path for the tractor. You see, I have all my wood chips here, so I don't want to be locked in, right? The garden has already cut off one of my paths. I'm used to just coming straight across, but I can't just come straight across the garden. Things are in the way. I also used to be able to come up through this and come through the garden, but the fence will stop me from doing that. Excuse me. Okay, so I'm going to have one path. I'm going to either have to come all the way around, which is not a problem. I've been doing that. Or I can go around the other way and come up this path. So as long as this area here is nice and open enough for me to get the tractor in here, I'm fine. When I get future deliveries of wood chips, I'll have the guy come and just drop the wood chips in this area right here where you see that other wood chip pile. So not a problem. But continuing along, we'll move this out the way because this is not really practical to bring the fence out, but so much. So I'm going to bring it up along this line that I'm walking here. And then you can see there's another gigantic tree stump right there. I'm not getting through that. So I'm going to have to come in and come through here to wrap around and get back to this corner over here. I want to come around this bird feeder here. So just to give you another angle, I have a straight shot here. I can get those T-posts into the ground, I'm pretty sure, with the post driver. But when I come in this way, I want to go around the bird feeder, around this curve here, and then straight out to the other end and just close off the corner. So this is not going to be a perfect rectangle. It's not going to be a straight line on the other side over there, but my first attempt at fencing is going to be this deer netting. My primary critter that I want to keep out of here is deer and rabbits. Deer netting will not stop a raccoon. So if a raccoon really wants to get through that deer netting, it will just go right through it, chew through it like it's nothing. But so far I haven't had problems with the raccoons in here or trying to get in here. And hopefully that will be a deterrent. If it's not a deterrent, well, we'll take down the deer netting and we'll put up some hardware cloth and maybe even do a second wrap around with some smaller posts and do some electric wiring. If the raccoons want to take it there, we can take it there. I will zap their little butts. But let's get started. I'm going to set up the gimbal so that I can film myself driving T-posts into the ground and capture as much of this process as possible so that I can share with you all. Peace. See you in a minute. So that's in it for now. So I thought I had 8-foot T-posts, but I actually only had 6-foot T-posts. And so we've got, wow, maybe I only have 5-foot T-posts because we've got about a foot in the ground. And this is how high it comes up to. A deer can jump this if it really wanted to, because it can jump up to 6 feet easily. Preferably 8 foot would be an ideal height. A lot of places even use 10 foot. But from what I read, the netting that I'm going to choose is supposed to be deer netting. They can't see it, so they are supposed to bump into it and get confused and walk away. So let's keep going. Okay, quick update. So you can see we started over here. We got 12 posts in. So we're gonna just keep coming around. And that's it. Whew. Boy, when I tell you this is a workout, this is a nice workout. I'm sweating like crazy, but I feel good. I'm not overexerting myself. I'm using nice rhythm when I pound. And I tell you, swinging the axe really got me prepared for what I'm doing right now, because I really believe that if I hadn't swung that axe for a couple of months straight, then I would be totally out of shape right now. And I think that includes traditional workouts with weights and stuff like that. They don't prepare you for what I'm doing right now, because what I'm doing right now is not just, you know, aerobic, but you know, you're using your shoulders, you're using your triceps, you're using your back, you're using everything. And so this is intense. This is like a high intensity workout. So let's keep it going. Thank you. Okay, so ran into a little bit, not a snag, it's not a snag at all. But so you can see the fence is coming around, turning inward, and turning inward again right here. So what we have right now, I can put the next post right here, and you can see I'll be lined up with the post at the other end. So I've got a mound of logs right here that the tractor can easily cut out, push out the way, I mean. And then I've got a mound of dirt right here, again, that I believe the tractor can easily push this out the way. If I have to get in here, and if I can't do it with the front loader, then I'm sure I can dig this up with the backhoe and just go ahead and keep going straight down, close the loop, and we'll figure out where we're going to put the gate at the time we're putting up the deer netting. Cool.